Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So this is Chandu Prashant. So today we are going to discuss about one of the technical seminar topic. So that is biochip technology. So see here, it is the photograph of a biochip. So it is very small in size. So biochip, it is actually inserted into the human body or pets for various applications. Fine. So let us discuss the applications first. Okay, so this small biochip is actually inserted into the human body for various applications, like it is used to detect the diseases early. So it is used as the oxygen sensor. So it is used to detect the glucose levels. So it is used for the tracing of a person. For all these applications, we are using this biochip technology. So it is a biochip. So actually, a biochip uses a RFID system using low frequency radio signals to communicate between biochip and a reader. Okay, so it does not contain any type of battery. So it is a one of the passive device. Fine. So it is a new type of biosecurity device to accurately track information and who is actually doing it. Fine. So let's move further. So actually, this biochip technology was originally developed in 1983 for monitoring fishes. So it is the outcome of the fields of computer science, electronics and biology. So this biochip is the outcome of various fields. Those are electronics, computer science and the biology. Bio plus chip, etc. Chip stands for computer chip. Actually, what computer chip will do? Computer chip will perform millions of or hundreds of arithmetic operations in a very few seconds. In the same way, biochip also do the hundreds of biological reactions in few seconds. So that is the specialty of a biochip. Okay, this biochip is a mate between biological entity and a computer chip. Fine. So size. Let's discuss about the size. So this biochip size is less like a uncooked grain of a rice. Okay, it is small enough to inject it under the skin using a syringe. So how it is inserted in pets and human beings? Okay, so biochip is inserted into the body with a hypodermic syringe. So it is the syringe. So by using the hypodermic syringe, we can insert this biochip into our body. Okay, so where it is inserted? So actually, in pets it is inserted behind the neck, but in humans it is inserted in the hands or in the forehead. Okay, so this injection, this hypodermic syringe, so with the help of hypodermic syringe it is inserted into the body. So this injection is very safe and simple when compared to common vaccines. Okay, we don't need any anesthesia and even not recommended also. Okay. So biochip technology, as I had already said, so this biochip uses a RFID, that means radio frequency identification system, that uses very low frequency radio signals to communicate between a biochip and a reader. Okay, so reader is one of the another device. So let's see the reader in the upcoming slides. So various components of a biochip. So the biochip has mainly two components. The first one is the transponder, another one is the reader. Okay. So, okay, fine. So, let's move further. So, it is the structure. Okay, it is the structure of this biochip. So, before that, see here, mainly two components. Remember guys, only two components, transponder and the reader. So, let's discuss about this transponder initially. So, it is the main component in the biochip. Okay, so transponder means it is a passive transponder. Passive transponder means it does not require any battery or energy. Okay, so it has a very long life and no maintenance. So being a passive, it is inactive until the reader activated it by sending it a low power electric discharge. So generally, this transponder is a inactive transponder. When it will going to activate, it will going to activate when the reader activate it by sending a low power electric discharge. So it consists of mainly four parts. Those are computer microchip, antenna coil, capacitor, and the glass capsule. So see here, antenna, so computer chip, and also it is a glass capsule. So it is the structure of a transponder. So it is one of the major component in the biochip. Okay. So let's discuss about one by one. Computer microchip. Well, computer microchip means, so the major disadvantage of this biochip is the storage capacity in this biochip is very very limited. Why? Because so it is a passive transponder, so it is a passive device, so that's why here the storage is very limited. So it is capable of storing a very single ID number having 10 to 15 digits. So its capacity is to store 10 to 15 digits only. Okay. So for each and every biochip has a unique ID. So it can have the capability of over 70 trillion unique numbers. So it can generate, for every biochip generates the 70 trillion unique ID numbers. Okay. So next one, antenna coil. Next component is in the transponder is antenna coil. So it is helpful to send and receive the signal from the radar. Okay, so let's discuss about the radar in upcoming slides. So next one, tuning capacitor. What capacitor actually do? Capacitor actually stores the electric charge which is sent by the radar, which actually activates the transponder. Okay, capacitor means it is just used to store the electric energy. That's it. So next component is a glass capsule. So it can hold the different components. So it is a glass capsule. It can hold various components like microchip, antenna coil, and capacitor. It can hold all the different components. So it is a 11 millimeter length and 2 millimeter diameter. So it is a biocompatible material. So after assembly, it is hermetically sealed. So it is the air. It is the airtight glass capsule. So let's see here. So it is the reader RF scanner. So it is the reader. So it is the photograph of a reader. So a reader generally contains this LCD screen. So see here, reader. So it consists of an exciter coil which creates an electromagnetic field to excite the implanted biochip. The reader carries a receiving coil that receives the transmitted code or ID number from the biochip. So reader main functionality is decode the received code and display the result in the LCD display. Simple thing, guys, is a transponder will acts like a sender. So this reader or a scanner will acts like a receiver. Simple thing. So reader acts like a receiver, transponder acts like a transmitter. So the transponder sends the ID numbers. The reader collects this standing this ID number, and this reader decodes it and will display simply in this particular LCD. That's it. Reader acts like a receiver, transponder acts like a transmitter, simply. Okay, so let's see the working. So in order to get more clarity on the biochip technology working, so let's see the working. So working of a biochip. Actually, this particular reader will generate a low power electromagnetic signal. Okay, low power electromagnetic signal. So in order to activate the implanted biochip. So the biochip, after that, whenever the signal is electromagnetic signal is sent by the reader, it will catches the biochip. So then biochip will activate. Then biochip will send a ID number to this particular reader. Okay, this reader will convert that ID into the digital format and decodes it and display the ID number on the LCD display. Okay. So again, this number is then compared with a database listing of already registered details. Why this comparison is necessary means, for example, this compared data is collected with the healthy human being data. So if there is any difference, it can treat data as a diseases. Okay, so in order to identify, this comparison is mainly because to identify the diseases. So it can compare the collected data with the healthy human being data. If there is any mismatch, it can treat it as a disease. See, if there is no mismatch in the collected data and the already available data, so it cannot be treated as a disease. So then the particular person will be healthy person. okay, mainly this comparison is mainly used for the detection of diseases, for example, I can say. So let's see the applications and advantages and disadvantages of a biochip in upcoming slides. So biochip perform early detection of diseases. Already I had said biochip main function is it is used to detect the diseases. Okay. So next one. So biochip acts like a glucose detector. So it can monitor the glucose levels in the body. So biochip underneath the skin sense the glucose level and sends the results back to the system out by a radio frequency communication. Simply, so the biochip identifies the glucose levels in a human body. Okay. So another one is biochip acts like a oxygen sensor. So during this COVID time, so it is required to monitor the oxygen levels frequently. So if you insert the biochip into our body, it can automatically monitor your oxygen levels. Okay, so it is a major application of a biochip in this nowadays. So biochip can be integrated with the oxygen sensor. So that means it can use it to identify the oxygen or glucose level in the blood. So next one, biochip has a BP sensor. For normally, sir, for BP patients, so continuous monitoring of BP is required. So that's why if you insert this biochip into our body, so it can monitor the BP continuously. Okay. So next one. So another applications are also there. So other than the medical applications, they have different applications of biochip. So tracing of a person or animal anywhere in the world is possible. So this can biochip can insert into the human beings as well as in pets, animals, etc. in order for the tracing purpose. So it can store and update financial, medical, demographic data of a person. So we can use it in the e-commerce systems also. So it can replace the passports, cash, medical and records. Okay. Biochip leads to a secured e-commerce system. So next, advantages. So already I had said it is used to locate the lost people and wandering Alzheimer's patients. So it is to identify a person uniquely. They can perform, this biochip can perform thousands of biological reactions in a very few seconds. So it can monitor the health condition of the patients. Okay, it can use to detect the diseases. It can store the financial data. So it can use it as a, so it can use it to store different types of the data. Fine, but here storage capacity is very limited here. So it is some disadvantage. Anyway, it can store, but storage capability is very limited. It can store up to 10 to 15 digits, that's it. So every system has the unique advantages and disadvantages. This biochip has also some disadvantages. Let's discuss one by one. So there rise critical issues of a personal privacy. So main thing is this biochip technology is one of expensive technology. So there will be a chance of turning every person into a controlled person if you insert the biochip into our body. Okay, biochip can be fixed into human body without their interference also. Okay, so it is a major disadvantage of using the biochips. Okay, another disadvantage also is there. So let's see that. So let's back to our diagram of a reader. So photograph of a reader. Here the reader must be in range of 2 to 12 inches near the biochip for communication. Why? Because this reader will generate very low frequency signal. That means the biochip, the implanted biochip and the reader, the distance between the implanted biochip and the reader is just 2 to 12 inches. So if that distance is increased, so it can't detect the diseases properly. So it is a major disadvantage of this biochip technology. So in order to overcome this disadvantage, we can embedded or we can connect this particular biochip technology to the IoT for better performance. Okay, thank you.